start with opening remarks. The first person will be Frank Sosby, then Jeff Perry, Jeff Johnson, and then Tony Wooten. Opening remarks to begin with. You have 2 minutes to offer your opening remarks at this time. Frank Sosby's first.
I hope everybody can hear me. I am kind of loud, so big guy. I've got 32 years of law enforcement experience in all facets of law enforcement. Right now, I'm currently with the Georgia Department of Corrections at Hall County Correctional Institute, where I'm the chief of security there, and we're seeing 200 convicted felons. We send these guys out every day to work, about 160 of them. But not only that, I have an education that I'm fixing to graduate my bachelor's degree in 2 months. I've worked on this, and I'm proud of it. I am going to pursue my master's in public administration after that. That is a goal I've set for myself, whether I'm sheriff, whether I'm still at Hall County, or wherever God has me. But I have executive training. I have management training. I have supervision. I'm actually a reconstructionist. I've worked in all areas from homicides, child molestations. I've done all this. There's nothing I haven't done. I want to be your sheriff. I've worked 32 years to be where I'm at tonight. And I feel that I am capable of being the next sheriff of Dawson County and leading this county and y'all citizens, with y'all's help, into the future. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Jeff Perry, and if you take anything away tonight about me, I'd like for you to remember these four things, and I call them my four C's. Number one, I'm a Christian. I stand on my faith. The second thing, I'm a constitutionalist. I believe in the Constitution. I believe it's more than just ink and a paper. I carry a book with me about the Declaration of Independence and the U.S. Constitution. Third, I'm a conservative. And that's the way I'm a fiscal conservative when it comes to fiscal responsibility. And then the fourth is common sense. You know, somewhere along the way, in the last 20 years, maybe further, we lost common sense in government. We need to get back to that. I'd like to share with you a few things about my background. My name, like I said, is Jeff Perry. I have a degree in criminal justice from Georgia Southern College. I'm completing a master's degree at the University of North Georgia. I completed a certified public managers program at the Carl Benson Institute at the University of Georgia. Almost 30 years experience working in law enforcement. The last 18 as a chief parole officer, managing a district consisting of 7 counties and multiple staff. I set priorities, I set operational strategic plan, I directed operations, I managed the budget, and I managed people. And I made the tough decision that comes with that. So, again, my name is Jeff Perry. I ask for your vote on May 24th. Visit us on our website, votejeffperryforsheriff.com. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming. It's my pleasure to be able to stand here and be a part of this process. There's a couple of things I'm going to share with you tonight. As I've lived in Dawson County for this, it'll be my 32nd year. I married my high school sweetheart here. We raised 2 fine sons. One of them's here now. One of them's living in Troy, Alabama. I'm vested in this community. I have a desire to serve our community in a far greater capacity. For nearly 24 years, I've served in a true law enforcement capacity. Now, you're going to hear folks talk about experience. And what I want you to leave from here tonight is realizing what your sheriff's office is comprised of, what duties and responsibility. You're tasked with electing your next sheriff. And first question that we need to ask ourselves is, what does that experience entail? What does that position require? And I think it's very, very important that we need to educate ourselves as to what exactly your sheriff does. Are we electing a figurehead, or are we electing a sheriff, someone that's going to roll his sleeves up and go to work, basically? I grow tired of politicians that hold offices, and I assure you that I will not be one of those. I've worked patrol. I cut my teeth in the jail. I've had some good detention experience. I've worked patrol for numerous years. I've supervised and served in investigations in special assignments. I was over I served sometime in a multi-agency task force for a while. Ladies and gentlemen, your sheriff's office is a multifaceted organization. And ladies and gentlemen, I ask you tonight to consider consider the experience that's required that goes along with this, title. Ladies and gentlemen, I seek to serve you. I want to get involved as I get out and talk to folks. I hear their concerns. I see what they want. I hear their concerns about investigations, about being cared for. Ladies and gentlemen, I seek to serve in a far greater capacity. As your sheriff, if you so elect me, I promise that I will be involved. Thank you.
All right, no matter what I do, I can't sit down. No matter what I do with the last name W, I end up being last. I don't know how that works in life, but we always end up being last as W's. Yeah, Z's there for y'all. So, for me, you know, I'm Tony Wooten, by the way, in the sheriff's office. I've been here 18 years with the sheriff's office. I start my 19th year next month. You know, you hear a lot of people talk about what they've done. You know, to me, you got to look at what, seeing the results of that, because too many times in elections, you hear promises. And you know, you may hear those tonight with what I'm going to do. And I get tired of hearing those. Let's look at people's results and what they've done for the community. And that's what I feel like we should be looking for as our next sheriff, is the person that's been out, that's been doing these things. People say that, you know, I want to do this, I want to do that if I'm sheriff. But why haven't you been doing that for the last few years when you've been here? Why do we wait until the time? And I say this every election with the sheriff, every election with anything else that goes on. Every 4 years, somebody steps up and says, hey, by the way, Dawson County, I love you. This is who I am. I know you don't know me, but I love you. You should know the person. You should be able to see that this person's been dedicated to your community. And I feel like that I've been that. As far as experience, you know, I've worked in every aspect. I started here in Dawson County 18, almost 19 years ago. I started in the jail. I worked my way to the top in several different divisions. I've been the division commander of every single division except for one in the sheriff's office. I think that's important. I believe on day one, when somebody takes over, they need to understand what the sheriff's office is. They need to understand day one how to take over the sheriff's office and how to run that sheriff's office. And I believe with my experience running your investigations and your patrol division and those things, I believe I have that experience. Again, I ask for your vote on May 24th. Thank you.
Each of you will now have 3 minutes to summarize what you have said tonight or provide any other closing remarks that you might have. 3 minutes, and we will start with Mr. Wooden.
I get to go first for a change. The last names, feel good about this. The, you know, for me, it's simple. I go back to, I've said it a million times, and I'm going to keep saying it. It's been my passion. I believe that you need to look for somebody that's passionate as your sheriff. I don't believe you're going to look on the stage and find anybody that's bad. Nobody here is somebody that's not going to be able to hold this position if you elect them. I think all of us are going to get everything that we have. I think it's simple. It's who do you think is best, that cares most about the community? I believe that's me. I believe I've shown that for the 18 years. It's not just that I have the heart, it's that I have the experience that goes with that heart. I've been the commander of every division but one. I worked that division when I first started out. I've been everything that you can possibly be in the sheriff's office to make sure that I'm prepared for this. I've moved around different positions to get the experience that I need, that if I choose to do this one day, that I'd be ready to be your sheriff. I feel like the day that I walk in the sheriff's office that I am prepared to take over that. I've ran patrols. You know, one of the endorsements I got lately that means the most to me, my wife can tell you, I actually started crying when this lady sent it to me. 7 days we searched for these two kids a few years ago. You'll probably remember that. 7 days. I was the patrol division commander, the investigations commander, the public information officer. I met with the family daily, make sure that us and the GBI work together every day to make sure that we work together and got along, which is a challenge sometimes, to make sure everything that went well for that. But when this mom sent me an endorsement letter saying, you are the right one for the job, that didn't turn out well. That, like, we found that lady in the lake. But for 7 days, relentlessly, I worked that case. I was the first face she saw every morning. I was the last face from the sheriff's office she saw every night. That's the commitment that I believe that you need as your sheriff. It's not an 8-to-5 job. I come in, we're having a revival of our church. I couldn't even stay there because I know this lady's lost her kid. Her kid is lost right now. She doesn't have an answer for where her kid is. Both moms, both dads don't know where their kids is. I can't just go home and say, what's on TV? I'm not that kind of person. I'm the person that's going to go out. We're going to turn over every stone that we can, and we're going to find ways to be able to prove and give those answers that we need to those people. And I think that's the experience that you need. You need somebody that can say that they've led those kind of things, that they've been in charge of investigations, that they've been in charge of patrol. You can't just simply say, I've done that. We've got new people right now today that just started. They've done that. They're not ready to be your sheriff. You can't just simply say, I've done that. I think the most important thing is to say, I've led that.
I've already shown the success. You heard on the stage today, everybody's talking about crime reduction. I appreciate that. Like I said before, we have reduced crime. You heard people talk about gangs. And I'm going to tell you, one of the persons sitting here can attest to this is Johnny Holzclaw. We've had kids that come into our school system that tried to start gangs in Dawson County. We ran them out of Dawson County. That's why you don't have gangs, because we've been doing stuff. Not because we've been sitting around talking about what's going to happen, because we got after it then, and we'll continue to get after it if I'm elected sheriff. Thank you.
Mr. Johnson.
Ladies and gentlemen, your sheriff is tasked with providing certain duties and responsibilities. And there's a Georgia code that lays them out. It's running a jail. It's running civil processes and serving civil processes. It's in jurisdictions such as ours that are smaller. It's about providing patrol enforcement services. Ladies and gentlemen, and I wouldn't say anything bad about a community program because I'm involved in a lot of them. Ladies and gentlemen, you're electing a sheriff. You're electing someone to enforce the laws of this county, to treat people right, to treat people fair, to treat people with respect and dignity. Ladies and gentlemen, the liability is far too great for us to risk. And what I mean by that is simply this. In today's society, it's a very litigious society. And as law enforcement officers, we have certain duties that we execute. Anytime we put our hands on someone, we have seized them in the eyes of the court. We have to justify that seizure. And that means that hopefully we're mature, hopefully we're making good decisions, hopefully we're making them with probable cause, hopefully we're making them in accordance with state law, with case law, such as that. Ladies and gentlemen, you're tasked with finding a sheriff, someone to lead your department for the next 4 years. I'm all about community programs. I believe them, I support them. But there's a bigger picture at play here. This is law enforcement that affects the entire county as a whole. And ladies and gentlemen, I submit to you, I don't claim to know it all, and the day that I do know it all, it's time for me to go. It's time for me to step aside and let somebody else have the reins. But I've been fortunate. We have progressed. I've spent my entire career in a patrol capacity, in a supervisory capacity, serving, commanding investigations, patrol, specialized multi-agency task force, things of that nature. I've spent my career as a teacher, as an instructor. I've spent time trying to teach and educate and help. You've all heard the saying that the best teacher in life is experience, and I believe that. Ladies and gentlemen, life's a hard teacher sometimes, but thankfully that we've learned from them, that we've been able to apply them. Ladies and gentlemen, you're going to elect a sheriff, and this sheriff has got to be a representation of the people. He's got to be a representative of the people. And he's got to make the wise decisions to keep us out of liability, to keep us from getting exposed to liability. Ladies and gentlemen, I pledge to you this. I ask for your vote. I ask for call me. If you have questions, if you have concerns, my education, my training is all an open book, and I'll be glad to share it with you. But I ask for your prayers, and I ask for your vote on May the 24th. Thank you.
Mr. Perry.
Thank you. First, I want to thank you for coming out here tonight. It's very important to be informed. I want to thank the Dawson County Republican Party, Tea Party, and the Foothills Women Program for putting this on tonight so that you could learn about each candidate up here. I'll begin by saying this right here in my closing remarks. My father, my Aunt Sharon's here, my father's sister. My daddy, he had a limited education. But he was a hard worker. He was still driving a truck when he was 78 years old when he died. He had three things that he told me that I remember to this day and everything. He was treat people the way you want to be treated. The second thing was if you go to work for, do a dollar's worth of work, then you give that man a dollar's worth of work. And the third thing was never quit learning. I was the first person in my family to ever complete college. And after that, you're talking about the leadership role, when you have cousins and other cousins see you do it, and they know you can do it. I brought that same thing to the work as a leadership for the state of Georgia for 30 years. I had the highest retention rate when I retired, and I also practiced what was called results-based budgeting, meaning that if we were funding something and it wasn't getting results, then we had what we would set as our meter. If we didn't reach that goal, then and we weren't going to fund that program again. Now, I said this before, I said this countless times, the way government used to be, we cannot function no longer. We saw that in 2008. We had to be smarter with the money. We had to be innovative. We had to think outside the box. And that's why I told you, we closed two or three offices that was under me. We sent people home to work from their homes and vehicles, and you had technology to do it. And that right there, that saved $2 million that we returned to the general fund, which was your dollars, and not one employee, again, faced a furlough or was laid off a day. And then you look, I go back and look, when I retired, I said I had highest retention. When I retired, I had four of my people retire with me. And the other chiefs throughout the state would come up where you had a high turnover rate, and they wanted to know what we're doing. And the thing was, it goes back to those three principles that I just discussed with you that my dad told me. Treat people the way you want to be treated. When you get paid for a dollar's worth of work, then you give that man a dollar's worth of work, and never quit learning. So as your sheriff, I hope you elect me on May 24th, because we do. You have to know who you want to be the face of Dawson County Sheriff's Department in the next 4 years. If you have a crisis here, who do you want leading that? Someone with experience who's led on a national level with the state Olympics in 96, and also the G8 Summit. And you want to see something that will try your leadership skills. I was the leader of Atlanta Police Department
very much.
When I was down there. Thank you.
Mr. Sosby?
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm asking up front for your prayers and your support and your vote for your next sheriff. And the reason I'm asking before that is my experience of leadership working with these officers hand in hand, side by side. I know what it's like to be in a control room and nobody ever comes and checks on you during the day. I know what it's like when the sheriff doesn't walk down and greet you or hasn't been down there in 6 months, down in the booking, or riding out on patrol with you. I know what that's like. You gotta have somebody that cares, and I care. I care for every officer in this department up here, every officer. Now, when I come in as sheriff, what my vision is I'm gonna put a school resource officer in every school. We don't have that right now. I don't know if anybody knows that. That's first. Our children being protected is top priority to me and our teachers. Secondly, we're gonna work on the drugs in this county. I'm going to join force with Sheriff Gerald Couch. We're going to bring some money back into this county. We're going to work on a criminal apprehension unit, suppression unit, to deter crime in this county, because we're going to be faced with it. Over the next 5 to 10 years, we're going to see a growth in this county like we've never seen before, unless somehow our government can slow it down. A sheriff's going to have to be somebody that's going to have to be able to go in a commission room and sit down with them as a friend, not a foe, and actually work together side by side, hand to hand. I believe in that strongly. And work on a budget for this county. Not asking everybody for tax dollars. Not asking everybody to, you know, give everything you got till you bleed. We're not going to do that. That's not what I'm about. We're going to reorganize this department, like I said before. With that reorganization, we're going to be able to put funding back into these officers' pocket. So that need cost the U.S. taxpayers. If anybody would like to see that, please call me. I'll be happy to sit down with anybody in here that would like to see that. I can show you how it can be done. I've worked on this for the last 4 years, and it can be done. It's just reorganizing this department. And it's going to put more people out on the streets, which we're going to need, and no cost to U.S. taxpayers. You've got my word on that. I'm going to be working, like I said, with y'all, our taxpayers. I'm going to be visiting you. If you get tired of seeing this big old face coming or driving up your driveway or somebody coming in there to see you, it's going to be me. I believe in that. I totally believe in that. My grandpa, my daddy, all of them taught me from a young, very young age. When I was helping them plowing a field up there, trying to raise watermelons, selling produce up there, I know what it's like to get my hands dirty and my feet dirty because I didn't wear shoes back then. So, nothing like having a little red clay, but I wish you both one. Thank y'all.